Hello and welcome to the session. In this session, we shall study the concept of samples and population. Suppose in a city, there are various ice cream parlors. Which sell variety of ice creams like vanilla, butterscotch, almond, chocolate, etc. A journalist wants to know which the most famous ice cream parlor is. So that he can write an article on it. What will he do? He will ask the people of the city which their favorite ice cream parlor is. But question arises, will he ask each and every person in the city to know most famous ice cream parlor? If no, what will he do? The answer is, he will select any number of people from the city and ask them about the parlor and will draw a conclusion about the most famous parlor in city. The name of the ice cream parlor which most of the people will take will be the most famous parlor. Suppose there are 300,000 people residing in this city. And the journalist chooses 1,000 people to answer the question. Then 300,000 is the population and 1,000 is the sample. Thus we can say population is the entire group of people or objects. And sample is a part of the population . Remember, it is not necessary that population should include people only. Population can be of any item or object, living or non-living. It depends on what do we want to know. For example, a factory manufactures toys. The owner wants to know how many of them are defective. So, he chooses any number of toys and counts how many are defective and draws the conclusion. In this example, the toys manufactured is the population. And the chosen toys form the sample. Also, we note that the sample chosen is random, it means we can select any object or person without any preferences and this is called choosing the sample randomly. Now in the above example, we chose 1000 persons from 300,000 people. It means size of the sample depends on the size of the population. It means if we are having 200 objects as population, then we can choose sample of 15 objects. We can summarize the above as a sample is some portion of a larger group called the population. Since it is impossible to examine every item in the population, a sample is selected to represent the population. After the sample is analyzed, the conclusions can be drawn about the entire population. The larger the sample size, the more closely it approximates the population. It means our conclusions regarding the entire population will be more accurate. Now we are going to discuss reasonable sample. Now question arises, how can we select samples which gives us the most accurate conclusion or prediction? Chosen sample gives us the correct inferences about the population if it satisfies the following conditions. And the first condition is sample should be selected at random. Second, it should be a representative of the population. Thirdly, it should be large enough to provide accurate data. If the sample satisfies these three properties, then it is the best sample chosen from the population. Let us take an example, identify the sample and the population and examine whether the sample chosen is reasonable. The school principal wants to organize a two-day cultural and technical fest for the students. He randomly asks 100 students whether they would like to participate in the event or not. Population of the students in that particular school is 2000. Here, all the 2000 students form the population and randomly selected 100 students make the sample. So here we have population,
which is given by 2000 students, and the sample, that is 100 students,
to check whether the sample chosen is reasonable, we must see that these three conditions are satisfied by the sample, that is, sample should be selected at random, it should be a representative of the population, and it should be large enough to provide accurate data. Now we know that here the sample is randomly selected, so the first condition is satisfied. Now 100 students of school can be of any grade, and these students are chosen from the same school, so it is a true representative of the population, so second condition is also satisfied, and we are choosing 100 students from 2000 students, so it is a large enough sample for the school population, therefore the third condition is also satisfied. Since all the three conditions are satisfied, thus we can say the sample chosen is reasonable. And this completes our session. Hope you enjoyed this session.